What's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. So today's video, we're throwing it way back. We're doing a why I quit my job story time. And actually, this is gonna be three different jobs that I quit. I'm just gonna loop them all into one because they're kind of like short little stories about why I quit each one because I really didn't stay at these jobs for very long. One of them, I only worked there for like, I think it was like not even 2 weeks. If you don't know already, my number one video ever on my channel is why I quit working at Sephora. That one has like 2.8 million views, and then I did another one about why I quit my job, and it was me working at a tanning salon. But I was just like, wait a minute, why haven't I done why I quit these other jobs? Like, they're such good stories. So I thought I'd loop them all into one. I'll start with Victoria's Secret. So I did work at Victoria's Secret. I worked at a bookstore, which I worked like, oh my God, that was so weird. I also worked as a hostess at like a local restaurant. So I'm gonna go through all of those. Before you do anything else, make sure you like and subscribe to this channel because you don't wanna miss more story times, okay? So let's just get into it. So let's start with Victoria's Secret. So I started working at Victoria's Secret when I was a sophomore in college. I had almost $0 in my bank account. I had like $3 to my name and I could not even fill up. I had a moped that I drove around Iowa City because I used to go to the University of Iowa. I couldn't even fill my moped up because I had no money. I kept going to the bars, I kept drinking, and I would buy alcohol and like outfits. If I got invited to like an 80s party, I would spend my last dime on stupid 80s clothes that I would never wear again instead of like food and anything like that. So I was not very smart with my money. So I decided I needed to get a job and I needed one now. So there was a mall that was not far away. It was probably like 20 minutes, but I literally used to ride my moped there, sometimes with somebody on the back of my moped, and we would ride 20 minutes all the way out there. We would have to go on like such a busy road. I cannot even believe it. And I would used to put my bags on the steering wheel and drive like that. Like, not cool. It was very dangerous. So anyway, so I went, I asked for a job interview, and this is a mistake too, and I just want to tell you guys, I went in on a Saturday and it was so busy. And as a rule of thumb, you should always go in during a weekday and ask for an interview in person because Saturdays are so busy and they don't want to like, people get very annoyed, you know. So anyway, that's just a tip that I learned, but I did not know that. So I went on a Saturday, asked for an interview. They said, sure, you know, we'll email you or whatever, we'll call you. So they called me, went in for an interview. It was a three-person, it was like a group interview. Interviewed, it was super easy. I'm pretty sure everybody that interviewed got the job. And I had like studied so hard. I was looking up how to get a job at Victoria's Secret. What are the questions they're going to ask? Like, I was researching for hours, I remember. And then they asked me like two questions and that was it. And then they just hired everybody. So I got hired as a sales associate. So I walked the floor with like the little headset. I got people in dressing rooms, all that stuff, whatever. So I was walking around doing the sales stuff, and for a while it was like, okay, you know, you train for a little bit, but pretty much they just threw me in there and I was just like, wait, what? And I would just walk around kind of like a headless chicken, like I didn't know where anything was. But we did have headsets. Like, somebody's on the headset every single day saying, like, every single hour saying, you need to make more sales in this room, we need more sales in this room, blah, blah, blah. And I was freaking out because I'm like, oh my God, like I'm super eager to please. So I was trying to do a good job, and like, you're supposed to be like pushing these sales and going up to people and like getting your name out there. And then it became like a commission. The time I got hired, it was like a commission-based thing. So you kind of had to like grind out there and like go up to people and make sure that they knew your name for the register. It was nuts. So I would go out there and I would just be like, I really don't like approaching people too. And like, you know, if somebody's got a question, they'll come up to me. I just like to make myself be seen. Like, everybody can see me. So if you need a, you know, if you have a question, then just come ask me. I don't like to go up to people because I know I hate when people come up to me and say, do you need help? Do you need help? Whatever. Anyway, it was just boring. Like, honestly, I don't even remember a lot of it. This was probably now, this is like 2 or 3 years ago, but it was so boring. I hated it. Every night after work, you have to fold all of the underwear. Every single piece of underwear on that underwear table. That is why every time I go into Victoria's Secret now, I don't even touch that table. Like, and if I do, I will fold everything back up because I know at the end of the day, that is like the underwear table of death, you guys. It sucked. I hated it. I dreaded it. And it keeps people there. I mean, any Victoria's Secret workers, you can vouch for me. It keeps you there like 30 minutes to an hour after your shift ends. No joke. If you close, that's how long you're there. because it takes forever to fold. And it's like even every drawer has to look like super perfect. Like every day, every single day you have to fold that. And how do you even fold underwear? Like how do, I don't even know. So anyway, that was just the worst. Like I really dreaded it. Like honestly, the underwear table is almost the singular reason why I quit there. But one day when I was working there, there was this huge bitch who was the same as me. She was just a sales associate, but she had been working there for years, okay? She never got promoted to like a higher up, but she kind of had that idea in her head, like, I've been here for so long, so I can tell everybody else what to do. No, okay? There's probably a reason why I didn't get promoted in all these years. So anyway, so she liked to be really bossy. She'd always be on the headset telling people what to do. And, you know, I don't think that she liked new people, I guess, probably. I felt like sometimes she was trying to, like, haze people. I'm like, what's wrong with you? Actually, you know what it was? Oh, my God. No, this is actually, this is what it was. She wasn't even a sales associate because it kind of went, like, cashier. And then there was, or maybe it went, like, people in the back who would, like, do the stock room. And then cashier and then sales associate. So, like, there was kind of, like, a hierarchy. And I think I was actually above her, but I knew sales associate was above whoever does the back room. She actually did the back room. So she would always be pissed at people if there wasn't like enough stuff, or you would have to go back and ask her. And she just was like, had a real, you know, high opinion of herself. So, oh, I hated this girl. So anyway, she would sometimes come up and like bring stock out or whatever and just be like, when she was out of the back room, she really thought she was a sales associate. Like I said, she like thought that she deserved like a promotion, and you knew that she like was so angry about it on the inside. So every time that she would come outside or like fold something or put stock away, she would like ask people like, do you need any help or blah, blah. Oh, I know about that, blah, blah. You know what I mean? So whatever. So I didn't really care about her until the day that she confronted me, which this pissed me off so fucking bad. It still gets me so mad because I have like a revenge problem where I just like, I have like an anger problem. I was, again, working. It was one of my, this was probably my first week there. It was like probably the end of my first week. I'd probably worked 3 shifts before that. Every time you work, if you're a sales associate, you had to get like a key. It was like a little scrunchie almost with a key around it for the, to let people into the dressing rooms. So that's my job. But for some reason she would walk around with a key on her, and I didn't have, like, they didn't even have enough for the dressing room, so I didn't even get to walk around with one. So I needed to ask somebody else if somebody needed to get in the dressing room, right? So I remember clearly it was a mom and her daughter who was around my age, probably a little bit younger than me at the time, and she asked me if she could get into a fitting room. So I said, oh, sure, you know, being super nice and super polite. And, you know, like the retail smile or like the personality where like, hey, yeah, sure, here you go. You know, because you're trying to be the best employee ever. I go to open the room, but I'm like, oh, shoot, I don't have a, you know, a key or whatever. So I have to go. I see the girl because, you know, in Victoria's Secret, there's those long hallways. It was a huge store. So there's long hallways and I see that girl at the end of it, and I needed to get her key because she had one. So I said over the thing, you know, can somebody come over here really quick and just open this dressing room for us? We just need to get in. I don't have a key. So she comes over and she stomps over like it's like I just inconvenienced her to the max. Like she was so mad that I had asked somebody. It wasn't even her, I just asked somebody. So she comes over and she, you know, after she's stocking the stuff, she's finally up in the front, you know. I cannot remember exactly what she said, but it was something so rude. I was in shock. She said it to me. She was like something like, oh, I remember what it was. Yes, I remember what it was. Okay. So she opens it up and she's like, you know, so all this sass, like she's so fucking pissed. So she opens it up and she sees that there's clothes inside of the dressing room, right? So she goes and she's like, oh, by the way, because she thought that she had to train me. So she goes, by the way, you should never leave clothes in here for the next person. You should always take them out of here every time somebody leaves, by the way, just so you know. She said this in front of the two girls, like the two clients. I say clients, the two customers or whatever that were right there. And then she walks away, right? Stomps away. And I remember so vividly like it was yesterday, the mom and the daughter sit being like, oh my God, their mouths were dropped to the floor because she was so rude to me. And they go, that was really rude. Like they said that to me. So I said, oh, you know, like I just smiled. On the inside, I am fucking burning. Like I am, my blood is boiling. I was so mad, right? So I say, oh, you know, here you go. Blah, 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 like, here's your dressing room, you know, it's totally fine, blah, blah, blah. after that, I had, like I said, I have kind of like a problem where I have to tell people how, like, tell them off if they are so rude to me like that. I walk over to the girl. She's folding, you know, whatever, doing whatever. She was floored when I did this. Okay. So I go up to her and I say, you guys are going to think I'm so bad for this. But remember, I was like so mad. And like, I can't even describe to you how mad, like how rude she was to me. So I go over to her, right? And I've got nothing to lose because I hate this job. And I'm like, you know what? I'll get another one somewhere else. Like, I don't really care. So I walk over to this girl. God, I wish I could remember her name. I walk up to her and I say, if you ever speak to me like that in front of a client again, I will make sure that not only that you lose your job, but I will ruin the rest of your fucking life. I literally could not believe the words are coming in my mouth, but I was so fuming, dude. Like, she was so rude to me, and she'd kind of been like that, like, a little bit. And I mean, I was not, believe me, I was not gonna try to ruin her life. Like, I didn't care that much about her, but I really needed her to know that that shit's not gonna fly with me. She can bully everybody else, boss everybody else, but she's not gonna do that to me, right? She stood there and she just goes and then I turn on my heel and I walk away, and I'm just like, I felt so fucking good, dude. And I went back and I, like, pretty sure I made a bunch of sales or whatever. But anyway, oh my God, I just remember the look on her face, dude. It was so priceless. It was so priceless. So anyway, a few days later, I quit. And the reason why I quit was because I got really sick. Like, I was getting really, really sick at that point. And I was super depressed in college. Like, major depression had set in by that point because I was dealing with, like, my illness, and I didn't know what it was, and I was trying to figure it out, and I was constantly having to drive back and forth between Iowa and my house, which was 3 hours away, and I would be driving back every weekend because I had to go to the doctor, or, like, you know, nobody was taking me seriously, blah blah blah. So I found a sublet for my apartment. I lived with three other girls. I left the University of Iowa totally. So then I was like, okay, well, I gotta quit my job. So I went in there one day and I just, like, said, you know, sorry, this is kind of random, but I'm quitting. But I didn't work there for very long. I probably worked there for like 3 weeks. And but I did make a lot of money. The minimum wage in Iowa is actually a lot more than it is here. But that is why I quit Victoria's Secret. That was a quick little story. And you know what? I think Victoria's Secret is probably a pretty good company to work for. So yeah, there's nothing really wrong with Victoria's Secret. I really hated it. And like, anybody that has to fold the underwear table of death, you deserve a raise. Next story. This one's not so bad, so I'll do this one next. So the next one is, I worked at a local restaurant where I live. And I got this job the summer after my senior year of high school. I needed a job. This is my very first job I ever had. My mom said, you know, you probably should get a job. This is the first place that I went. Was like, I was just like, oh, it'll be easy to be a hostess, right? And it's pretty easy. So I went over there. It's the most poppin' restaurant probably in town. I was just like, you know, that sounds like a good place to work, I guess, you know, whatever. So I got a job the very day, like, she interviewed me, and then I got a job that same day. So I went home and I'm like, Mom, I got a job, you know, whatever. So I think I lied on my application saying that I already had a job before, but I didn't. So I worked there the whole summer, but there was a few things that happened where I was like, oh my God, that's so annoying. I mean, stuff's gonna happen everywhere you go, so don't think that I'm like a huge complainer or anything. Like, I know that stuff happens everywhere that you work, and, you know, crappy situations, whatever. But this was so crazy because I didn't realize it was gonna be so strict. The dress code for the hostesses was so strict. It was insane. I was literally shopping at White House Black Market because nothing else was good enough for the manager. I was a teenager. I was 18 years old shopping at White House Black Market. Okay? What? I was literally dropping coin on clothes and that I could not even afford on my minimum wage salary. Anyway, so I used to have to get there because it was a breakfast restaurant. So I used to have to get there at like 6 a.m. or like 5:30 a.m. or whatever, and when it opened, and people would dead ass be there like at 5:30 a.m. whatever. But on Sundays, dude, it was insane. Saturdays and Sundays, I dreaded working because there was so many people there. Oh my God, there were so many people there. That was fine. I mean, I kind of freaked out because I was just nervous about, you know, seating people, and then waitresses and waiters would get so mad at me if I put somebody like that wasn't in their section, or if I skipped a section because somebody would say, oh, I don't want to sit there, or can we go sit over there instead, or whatever. And it was like a feeling of dread would come over me because I was, again, so eager to please that I wanted everybody to be happy, and it's like I couldn't make them happy because somebody always wanted to sit there, or, like, you know, people really want to sit in booths, and sometimes when you try to sit them in a table, they don't want to sit there. So you have to put them in a booth. So, you know, things would be crowded, whatever. I mean, it's whatever, but they would just get mad at me. And I was just like, oh my God, I don't know what to do. So that was not a big deal. I mean, whatever, whatever, right? So one time though, the manager was just so strict about our appearance. It was almost to the point where it's like, relax, okay? Relax. Nobody cares about what the hostess looks like. I mean, we were all presentable. We were all put together, whatever. There was a lot of girls that worked there, like my age, high school. And we all wore pretty, you know, good stuff. And in high school, by the way, you don't need to wear makeup and, like, you know, everybody looks cute and whatever. Everybody looked fine. So I distinctly remember one time it was a bunch of us working. It was a Sunday. And one of the girls that I worked with, she was about my age, was super, super sick. So she didn't come, she came in with no makeup on, but her hair was still done and she was still wearing, we had to wear dress pants. Dress pants. You'd think that I worked at Mastro's Steakhouse. I literally had to wear dress pants and like work tops. Like, you know what I'm talking about, like express work top. Do you know what I'm, like, I couldn't believe what I was wearing. I thought I was going to like the city to work. I mean, it was insane. I remember the manager coming up to her and saying, are you not feeling good today? Like, what's the deal? And the girl was like, wait, what? Like, what do you mean, what's the deal? She's like, I don't feel good today. I'm really sick. She goes, you need to put more makeup on right now. All of our mouths drop to the floor, dude. And we're just like, oh my God, like, that's like fucked up. Like, she doesn't need it. She looked fine to me. I mean, really. And like, she required us to wear makeup. I always wore makeup back then because, you know, hello? But yikes. And I just remember her like going in the bathroom crying. Like, it was a rough day, and I was just like, this is kind of fucked up. I cannot afford these clothes anymore, like, to work here. This is not okay. Like, I don't even make enough money to shop at White House Black Market. Like, I'm not even kidding. Like, Kohl's was not good enough. So another thing that happened, oh my God, this was so annoying, and this is probably like the last thing that happened, but one day I was, you know, doing my hostess duties, whatever, and I have, you know, long blonde hair. It is extensions, but it's long blonde hair, whatever. So you'll understand what I mean. So I'm walking back and forth as I do, whatever, whatever, right? One of the waitresses comes up to me and she says, just so you know, one of my customers just found a long blonde hair in their food. And she's like, so just be wary of that. And she goes, just so you know. And like leaves like that. And I'm like, what do you want me to do? Wear a fucking hairnet as a hostess? Like, are you fucking dumb? I mean, honestly, like, are you dumb? What do you want me to do? Like, seriously, what do you want me to do? Put it in a hairnet? Like, that's so fucking stupid. Like, do you think that I took my hair out and put it in their food on purpose? Like, stupid. Like, literally rude. Just stupid and rude. And I'm like, who do you think you are? Like, actually, who do you think you are? I just don't even understand it. And it could have been anybody's. I mean, it really could have been anybody's hair. You just, like, there's no way of knowing. And even if you took scientific data, like, it would probably show up as somebody else because this isn't even my real hair. So it's like, you'll never know. So why even bring it up? That's so rude. Like, what do you want me to do? Chop my hair off? Go bald? Like, dumb. So anyway, the reason why I quit that job is because after the summer, I went to college, they knew it, and I never went back there, and they never asked. They even see me, like, I don't go there anymore to eat because, like, I'm vegan and they have, like, nothing. So they've seen me before, though. Like, I've been back, like, a few times, and they've been like, oh, hey. So anyway, that's why I quit there. I mean, it wasn't that bad, but it was definitely, like, not my favorite. Not a dream job for sure. The last place I worked at was a bookstore. It was at my community college, and my cousin, well, she's like a half cousin or like second cousin, because our grandmas are sisters. So she's like my half. I don't know how that works. So she worked there and she like referred me. She's like, yeah, I worked here for a long time. Like, you should get a job here. It'll be super easy. And I was like, sure. Like, I already was going there. I was like, maybe I could just, you know, maybe I'll get free books. Spoiler alert, you don't get free books or even really a discount. I mean, you do, but not huge. So I interviewed and I was so nervous too. I was like calling all the time. I was taking it so seriously. And then I show up and I was doing like the, what kind of questions are gonna be, like, interview questions, right? I show up and it's a group interview. I did not know that it was gonna be a group interview. And again, it was kind of like around back to school time. So this was like right before school was gonna start again. So probably like August or yeah, probably like August. It was a huge group interview, but one of the people was late, 15 minutes late to be exact. And he finally showed up, didn't apologize, and he got the job. So basically they did not have a very strong vetting process. They didn't care if people were 15 minutes late to an interview. How unprofessional can you be? Anyway, whatever. So basically this was like a lot of people's first jobs, and I could tell immediately upon working there that it was a lot of people's first jobs. I had already worked like a good couple jobs before I started working there. So anyway, my cousin was like their favorite, their star pupil. They loved her. Anything that she said, anything that she did, they had her do everything. And like, she was basically working as the manager, as the same job as basically like what I was doing. Anyway, it totally freaking sucked. I hated every second of working there. I dreaded going there. This is the job I worked at for the least amount of time. I think I worked there not even 2 weeks. I thought it might be kind of fun. Like, I thought there would not be a lot to do, but you're always constantly doing something because there's always people watching you. So I would have to do the register, and it was just boring, and it was hard to like do all the books, and you had to deal with people's like financial aid and like put it in, and they would get all mad. Of course you'd get mad if you messed it up. I didn't mess it up, but it was just kind of difficult to understand, and there was people that like wouldn't help you on the register. And I'd be like asking for help, and like nobody would come over, and I'd have to wait there, and they'd be like, they didn't even know how to help me, and it was just stupid. So I got moved down to the basement, and it was the best day of my life because I got moved down to the basement where my cousin worked. She worked in like the warehouse downstairs checking books in. And I thought, this is so chill because the managers aren't on my back. Nobody can see what I'm doing down here. I can go on my phone. I was not a good employee back then. You know, but you really couldn't go on your phone because it was constant work. She had huge crates. Like, they overworked her, my cousin, so bad. They had huge crates, 10 crates a day, and she had to check every book in by herself. And like, I was her only help, so I actually did have to work a lot down there. And I would have to type books in and scan all these books, and like, they all had to go in a different, it's really hard to explain and super boring. I'm not even gonna go there, you don't care. So anyway, plus she had to like, while all this is happening, FedEx guys would come, UPS guys would come and drop all these things off. She'd have to sign them and like put them different places, and it was insane. And when people would come get their books, like online orders, and then she would have to like put all these orders together, and then she'd have to bring them upstairs and put them back away, all these books. I'm like, this is too much work. She was so stressed. I've never seen like a human being that stressed out before than seeing her. She was almost like a shell of her former self because it was so stressful for her down there, and she just had no help, and it was like two kids down there doing all the work for the entire bookstore, no joke. So I was just down there kind of like trying to help, like do my best, whatever. And every day my cousin is having nervous breakdowns because it was just, and there was nothing I could really do because nobody had trained me either, and there was just like, I could only do like basic stuff, you know what I mean? Meanwhile, like, the managers are coming downstairs, and it's just like, they were like yelling, and just, there was always something they needed, and they were like kind of catty, and like they felt kind of gossipy, and they were all part of a clique and whatever. And it was just a weird dynamic. It was a weird, weird dynamic. And my cousin would always have to warn me. She's like, oh, this person's like this, or be careful of that person. I'm like, oh damn, like, this is a bookstore, dude. Like, I thought this would just be a chill job. And it just wasn't chill one day. Like, it was just stressful for me to like see other people that stressed, right? I didn't know how to answer one question. Like, they would have me answer the phone sometimes, and I'd be like, I really don't know, dude. Like, I really don't know. Like, nobody told me the answers, right? People would probably be so frustrated calling in. They probably still are. It was run horribly. One day, this was so mean of me, but I truly did not know. They hired a second group of people while I was there. They were hiring tons and tons and tons of people, and there was just too many people, not enough people to train. And I was working, like, I just was in this weird place of the store working with one other girl. It was kind of like a back room. And we were sorting through books or whatever, you know, always sorting through books. And something really smelled. Like, the room really, really smelled. And it was to the point where I had to go like this, like, really in cover up because of my nose, because it was smelling so bad. So kind of to break the silence, because she was kind of like a very timid person, and, you know, not too, she just wasn't talking. So I tried to break, you know, the silence, the awkward silence. And I go, God, like, what's that smell? Like, I'm like, oh, I could puke. And I literally, like, I was gagging back there. Like, I just remember, so it was so like BO and like literal poop. Like, I'm like, disgusting. So I said that, I just said it out loud, and she's like, oh really, like I don't smell it. And we went back to like not talking, and then a little while later she goes to like take the book somewhere else or whatever, like she got called away to like do some other work or whatever, and I'm still in there. The smell immediately is gone. It was her. I didn't know, dude. Like, I felt so bad. It was her that smelled so fucking bad. And I'm like, I literally couldn't breathe. So, like, every day I would hold my breath. I would hold my breath. And I would have to come up with an excuse for why I had to leave that room. Because she smelled that bad. Like, I could not breathe. It was the most disgusting thing ever. So, that happened one day. I don't know what it was. I hated that job so much that I literally just called in. This is so unprofessional. Do not do this, you guys. Please, do not do this. But one day I just like, I think my dad had like Cubs tickets, and it was to like, yes, he got like free Cubs tickets. He got 4 Cubs tickets to go to like this underground, they have like a lot of underground, like it was the Audi Club. Yes, it was the Audi, like, you know, the car, Audi Club downstairs. You get free drinks and like you had like a skybox view. It was crazy, okay? Opportunity of a lifetime, right? He gets these tickets and I'm like, oh shit, I really want to go, but I had to work. So I just called in, and I thought I was just gonna call off, right? And like just say, sorry. I had already called off the day before too, and I said, sorry, I think I'm really sick, you know. So I called in and I just said, you know what? I'm actually just gonna quit. And she's like, excuse me? And I'm like, yeah, I just really don't wanna work there anymore. So just, you know, I'm really sorry. Tell my cousin I'm really sorry. And so I'm just not gonna come in anymore, thanks. Send the check to the online thing or whatever. So I just quit and I'm like, freaking done. But so this is what happened. We just had a family reunion a little bit ago, so my cousin just told me this because she worked there for like months after I quit. She said that at the very end, one of the managers, one of the mean catty like gossipy managers who was like super kind of mean to me too, she got caught in the service elevator. There was like an elevator that brought all the books up to the second floor. She got caught by one of the people like in the warehouse giving one of the other managers a BJ. Oh, I literally, like, they both got fired. Like, he went straight to HR, like the kid that found them. And they like, he was like, why is the elevator coming up? Like, he kept trying to get the elevator to come up and it wouldn't, like they had like locked it or something. I don't know what the fuck they did. And he saw them through the crack. Like, he looked down and saw them through the crack because he needed to get down to the warehouse, and he saw them. Could you imagine? Could you even imagine? So anyway, that place was like seriously messed up. Like, there could have been a TV show about that place. It wouldn't have been a good one, but there could have been. Thank God I quit that place, right? Anyway, those are the stories about why I quit my other jobs. I hope that you guys enjoyed the story times. If you want more story times, please make sure to like this video so I know. Subscribe to this channel if you are not already. Also, don't forget to follow me on my other social medias, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye. Just had to say you're the only one. I can't deny you the stall any longer.